100 to 10K, services, flipping, and investing.
So my strategy is gonna be a little bit different than Brian's. Oh dude, it is on.
Here we come, Jefferson.
What is going on, everybody? Welcome to the Friday live stream. We're not behind green screens right now. We're here. We're live in the studio.
My Small Hand.
Oh, I love that. That's a movie with Christopher Elliott. Take my strong hand.
We're in the studio for the first time together. We were not expecting this. We're like, all right, we ended up here at the same time. We're in Georgia. And this is our last time here before we move here permanently, which I'll be here in less than 2 weeks. And super excited about that.
Yeah.
Challenge has been going pretty good. Sold a couple items this week, so we'll talk about that. Justin, how about you? How's your week?
The week was good. You know what? I think, you know, one thing we talked about before we came on the air and came live with the stream today is that, you know, it was not a big flipping week. I didn't sell anything. You know, we were here. It was a big administrative week for us, though. We got a lot of things done. We had some great meetings with all of our team, with our graphic design team, our social media team, the editors. It was just, we got a lot done, a lot accomplished. That's going to set us up for the next couple weeks while you finish out your time in Florida. I'll be here mid-July coming from Austin, Texas. So, you know, I think we're very well set up for the next couple weeks to get a lot of things done before we do this full time. What's really going to be exciting, and I'm really looking forward to this, and we hinted at it last week on the stream, is that we're going to start doing 5 streams a week, and there'll be different themes throughout. Really looking forward to bringing those to you and kind of explaining, you know, what we're going to be doing on those.
Yeah, we also discussed like a new template for our 100 to 10K challenge videos. You guys kind of saw the trailer for that. And we're going to be pumping those out like once a week. So you're going to see every single item we bought, we sold, the numbers, everything. So that's going to be really detailed, really high action. And you'll kind of get a summary. These streams are more like the in-depth like guide of what we're doing, how we're actually doing it. And then we'll kind of give you guys like the sizzle every week too, which is going to be a lot of fun.
Oh, always got to sell the sizzle. I know that we love creating this stuff for you guys. I hope you enjoy watching it. We both hope you enjoy watching what we're putting out because we're having a lot of fun doing it for you, teaching you how to make some money. And eventually we're going to get in some more investing strategies, tips and tricks as well, because that really plays along with what we're talking about and the whole new money aspect of New Money Gang.
100%. And now that we have a little bit more money, we're going to be able to do a lot different things and show you guys some new stuff. So looking forward to that. We'll kind of give you guys an update at the end of the show, what we're going to do next week in the coming. So like for our challenge. And so that's going to be fun.
Absolutely. Speaking of money, you're crushing me in the challenge right now.
Just a little bit.
Ah.
Wait, double?
Bro.
Does it hurt?
It does. But you know what? Like, you know, we said this was going to take a little bit longer kind of than what we originally planned. So if you look, you know, you can pull that up, BJ. You know, if you look at the bankroll management right now, you'll see, you know, Brian's at $1,275 and I'm at $627. Now, I do have some crypto invested in there. And so, you know, that we're waiting for the markets to come back. I've got a bunch of the Graph GRT tokens. So everything's down right now. If you're, you know, if you pay attention to crypto, you know everything's down right now. So that isn't performing as well as I wanted to, but I know.
But that's a small percentage, right?
It's a small percentage.
Or like 20% or something like that.
Something like that. It was, you know, I think this was back. I mean, it was an 80% investment at the time.
Oh, wow.
So it was $150, I think, back when I had whatever 80% of $150 is. I'm not a mathematician.
$200. Yeah. Something like that.
Something like that.
Cool.
All right. So, weeks were good.
Are we going to get into the clickbaity title that we have for today?
Oh, yeah. I think it's really smart. Really smart that we do talk about that. So, you know, we always try to bring a little bit of education, a little bit of knowledge into this everything and try to make it relatable to, you know, what's going on in your world, in our worlds, in our lives and everything. So, talking about a side hustle as an insurance policy.
Yeah,
you never know what's going to happen. Obviously, nobody knew that a pandemic of proportion that we saw last year was going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, we've been on the street a lot lately, and we'll have a lot of this content coming out on socials. And we've just been asking a lot of people, like, what their side hustle is, or do they have a side hustle? And I tell you what, almost everyone says yes. I think I got, like, one no out of 10.
Right. You know, when we were at the Bitcoin conference, too, we asked a lot of these people and, you know, a lot of folks that were there saying, no, I don't have a side hustle. But then you just say, hey, don't you invest in crypto assets like Bitcoin, Ethereum, stuff like that? And they're like, yeah. We're like, well, that is your side hustle. I mean, that's how my side hustle started, right? Like, you know, okay. I was in the ground transportation and logistics world for the better portion of a decade. And obviously last year, everything that happened, you know, that wrecked my world, at least as far as, you know, my career went. But a few years before then, you know, I had started with the side hustle. I had been into crypto. I had been working for an exchange for a while. Ben with Bitboy Crypto and I had, we were doing a podcast. So I was in the space. It was something that really took a lot of my attention. And I really found out that I was passionate about it right off the rip. So it was a natural transition for me, you know, once kind of the career ended to come into this stuff full time. It was my insurance policy.
Question for you. Was like crypto profitable for you like early on, or was it like a grind to start, or I actually don't know. This is a real question.
No, it's a good question. So so I was working for an exchange, so I was getting paid by the exchange in cryptocurrency to do stuff. You know, I did a lot of their YouTube videos. Okay. And then because it was a newer exchange, which they're now defunct, but I also did a lot of the research. So I was, you know, reading white papers, researching all about projects and like, you know, interviewing and talking to these projects. So, you know, back in 2017 and into 2018, when I was doing that, I was getting paid in a lot of crypto. So it was very lucrative, you know, but everyone knows what happened, you know, when the market crashed. You know, I was left holding the bag, some pretty heavy bags. And so I ended up losing pretty much everything that I had made in that bull run.
Ouch.
Yeah. Yeah. So it was profitable, it turned out to be somewhat devastating. But, you know, everybody knows it's, you know, it's cyclical. The markets are going to come back. And we're kind of in a lull at this particular moment. But we know things are going to shoot back up pretty soon. So, yeah, to answer your question, it was a profitable, turned out to, you know, not be. But
so did you like work for just a crypto company to start, or did you invest first and then like through investing in it find this company?
I started investing.
Okay.
And then, you know, doing research on projects, I found this exchange, and then was approached to start doing their YouTube videos, and then from there really learned a lot more about crypto assets and kind of the whole ecosystem. And you know, that's right, it was baptism by fire for sure.
So you really dove in then.
Head first, man. You know, like I told you, you know, it was, and what we preach on this channel is turn your passion into a profit. You know, yeah. I found out very quickly that crypto, this industry, being able to be a part of it was something I became passionate about very quickly. And so I've done, in my opinion, a pretty decent job of turning this passion into profit. What about you?
I mean, yeah, I have a similar story with the crypto stuff for sure. I'll talk about that very briefly, and then I'll tell what story from like way back in the day when I started my first business. But yeah, crypto, man, it's we came into like 3 years ago. I think I dived in really heavily, and you know, but I literally lived in a van for like a year and just learned about crypto and made content about crypto to learn about it. So like that's my story with that. Like I kind of transitioned from like a full-timer like running a business to just like living in a van and learning about crypto. So that's my story on the crypto side of it. But I want to talk about something that like a long time ago, I started a printing business. I came up with a product. It's a sign. It's like a full color sign that was like much cheaper than anywhere else that anyone could get it. Mm-hmm. So like kind of developed this product with a partner, and then just like the partner and I had like a falling out, and they ended up like owing me a bunch of money. And it was kind of like a very frustrating experience where like I didn't want to go into work for a company where I like wasn't making money.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So like, but like on the side for years, I had been like studying intently and like learning how to play like poker professionally, which is like a very skill-based game. If you guys look up some articles on it, you'll know that a lot of people, like, I had to deal with like family thinking I was like a degenerate gambler. it was pretty bad, but basically I fell back on that because that was like my side gig. I'd do it for fun and I'd make a little bit of money on the weekends, whatever. But then once I wasn't making any money with my business, I was like, all right, I'm gonna dive into this. I'm gonna, you know, use bankroll management, have a set amount of investment, and make sure I'm being profitable. So I ended up playing poker for a living for about 7 months. Oh, now, wow. I didn't make a killing, but I made enough to pay my bills. I made about $2,000 a month. I was like 20 years old when I had this business, or 19, 20 years old. Mm-hmm. And so $2,000 for me, I was living with my parents. My bills were very low, was a good amount of money to, you know, keep me growing and keep me going. And that's just an example of something that was on the side that I ended up turning into a full-time thing. But
there's always a but.
But we need to talk about this. Is it always good to turn your side hustle into a full-time
gig? That literally was going to be the question that I asked you. I know that we talked about this, but what you said, there was a great segue into there, because you got to the point where it was enough for it to be your full-time, the financial aspect of it. It covered all your bills.
I was playing 40, 50 hours a week, so it was like a full-time job.
Okay.
But I hated it.
Really?
I loved poker, and I still do. I love it. But I hated it being my job.
Because it puts the pressure on.
It puts the pressure on. It's stressful. You have to be very, like, pay attention to, like, percentages and everything. You, like, know that you're doing the right thing over a long period of time, because there's variance and ups and downs. So you have to really make sure. But not only that, it's just when I turned something that I loved and was passionate about and something that I loved doing on the side into my full-time job, it became work. And it was just, I just didn't want to do it anymore. I had even people offer me, like, to back me, like, you know, to, like, do it full time and travel around and play. And even recently, like in 2016, like when I played at a World Series of Poker event and I did very well there. Yeah, if you Google me, you'll see.
Nice. Dude, that's awesome.
But I still to this day, no matter how much money I've ever made on that, it's not something I want to do full time. When I'm old and retired, maybe.
No, that makes some sense. Now, does like some people that play poker full time, you can have a sponsor, right? You can have like a sponsorship.
Yes.
And so that could be, you know, you could consider the sponsorship kind of your full time income and play the poker kind of as your side hustle. Like if you're getting paid two ways.
How it works, if you're good enough, like someone will pay for all of your entries, all of your cash entries, all your tournament entries, and you don't owe them back. It's not like a loan shark kind of deal.
Oh, really?
So you just can't play poker anymore if you lose. Yeah. So like if you lose and lose and lose and lose and your investor's not making money, then you just be like, all right, I quit. And you don't owe them any money, but you'll never be able to play poker again or cash in a tournament without paying off the losses to that investor.
That's basically like getting Munsoned.
I've never done it. I've never had a backer ever, because I just – even though it was free money, essentially, yeah. I just didn't want to have to split it with somebody either. It's like you have to split 50% or sometimes more, depending on what it is. So,
well, if they're going to bankroll you, I guess you do have to live up to some expectations. So, all right. So let's answer our question then. As far as being able to turn your side hustle into your full-time job, whether it's something, because you want to keep the passion, right? Because we always preach that on this channel, turn your passion into profit. If you don't like doing something, don't do it. That's our rule number one. So this week, one of the fun things that we did is that it'll be coming out next week or the week after, as we shot the New Money Gang 10 Rules of the Hustle. We'll teach you all about it coming up here. But the number one rule is do something you're passionate about. Do something that you love. Or else you're just going to, I mean, what's the point?
Yeah, there is no point. Like, I mean, you can, it's like, grind it out, but it's not fun. You're not going to do it for long. That's the thing. You're not going to do it for long. But, yeah, I mean, these side hustles, man, like, they're such an insurance policy. They really are. Because even if you don't want to do it full time, they still save you. Like, I mean, and you're learning something at the same time.
Absolutely. And, you know, like, what we're doing right now with this challenge, with the $100 to $10,000 challenge, I mean, we literally have turned free items into money. You're well over $1,000 at this point. You know, I'm a little bit farther behind, but I am going to be setting up a new goal. You know, it's Friday, June 25th. Our goals were due today. You crushed your goal. I didn't. So that now it's time to go back to the drawing board and rethink the strategy, right? So another one of the rules.
Think of my next goal.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to tell you mine right now. So really quick, another New Money Gang rules of the side hustle, or rules of the hustle, is to not set goals, but you set systems to achieve your goals, right? So for example, my next goal is by the time I move here, which we are going to be pulling out of the driveway of Austin, Texas on July 17th. So I will be in the studio full time with you following that following week. Our live stream, I believe, is what, the 23rd is what we said?
I think that's a Friday.
July 23rd. Yeah. So by July 23rd, my challenge bank will be at least $5,000. And over the next couple days, I will work on my systems that are going to get me there, and I will share them on social media because that's what we do. We try to be fully transparent with you guys and let you know everything that we're doing. So I will lay out my systems to help me meet my goals of being at least $5,000 by the middle of next month.
All right. I'm going to set a short-term goal, and I'm going to step it up a little bit because the last goal I hit kind of early and feeling good about that. So I'm going to try to keep that momentum going because goals really force me to, like, dig in because I like to keep my, like, you know, like, momentum and my word to myself. Like, it's hard. Like I have to be accountable to, like, Justin and to everyone that I'm now talking to on the interwebs. So, like, I'm gonna shoot for doubling my current amount by the next live stream.
By next week. Okay. All right. So I think you're at 1,200 and something bucks. So you're gonna be at close to 2,500. All right.
2,500 is my goal for next week. And my system that I'm going to do that is I'm going to, for the first time, spend some money on marketing.
Oh,
so the signs that I was talking to you about, I'm going to purchase them at full price for like $200. I'm going to put out some signs that said, like, I buy junk cars. And I'm going to go put them out and negotiate with some people to buy some, like, scrap metal and some parts and then deliver them to a junkyard. Yeah.
Cool, man. You know what I really like about that? And this is something, you know, we've talked about, you know, not only you and I, but, like, you know, even some of the guys here at the office, is that, you know, when we move into the new space, we're going to have a lot of space to be able to do, you know, some more things. And, you know, really getting into the automotive field is going to be a lot of fun to do. But I think that there's an opportunity for you and I to start a full-scale business of doing that as well, whether it's
100%.
You know, and this is going to be probably one of the live streams that we do in the future is when it's our board meeting, right? Our executive meeting where we talk about the businesses we start. But all right, so we need to get ourselves a tow truck because then we can cut out that middleman of having to pay a tow truck driver to pick up the car and take it. I think you have to do a bunch of work. You have to take it to the police department, do some other stuff, and then take it to the junkyard. Well, if we can take that, you know, out of the equation, that's just more profit for us.
Yeah, and we'll have to just calculate if that makes sense, and you have to make sure that you're doing enough volume to make sure that it, you know, makes up for the time that you would be spending, or, and then we also have to calculate in, like, hiring a driver. Like, is that going to be you or me, or are we hiring somebody else? So, you know, it's like all that stuff, we're going to really dive into it. We're probably going to do that on, like, our Tuesday live stream.
Yep.
So that's a preview of what's to come. We're just going to kind of dive into behind the scenes of all the numbers, what it takes to start whatever business that we start, because we'll probably start a few of them. And it's going to be a good time. I'm super excited about sharing, like, behind the scenes, because people don't get that. You know, people are scared to give it away because they don't want to give away secrets or show how much money they're making. Like, it's a bunch of BS.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, you have to actually do the work.
Right.
And then what are you scared of, like, competing against someone else? Like, that should drive you even more. Like, look at this competition. It should drive us to make more money. So
absolutely. And it's, you know, it's fun, friendly competition. So I think we got BJ, our producer, wants to say something.
Well, what I was going to say, I was pretty excited to do, is talking about a lot of these hustles, is when a lot of people are talking about Bitcoin and it not being green friendly, what I actually wanted to start doing is GM. Everybody loves doing LS motor swaps.
Mm-hmm.
They make an all electric.
Oh.
So what we could do is start buying cars with blown engines, swap them out, put in an electric engine, and then slap on, you know, New Money Gang or Powered by BitBoy Crypto or something to show that people in crypto actually care about making change. So our not only is our side hustle making us money, but it's actually environmentally and changing the community.
Oh, I love
that. It's all about that. It's beautiful.
So I love that. And everybody loves, you know, the LS swap right now is a huge thing.
Oh, yeah.
I know, you know, some of the other guys, like,
about it.
They're really excited about, you know, getting into the new space where we can, again, do some automotive stuff and do an LS swap. So, I mean, this will fit right into it. You know, we can find a junked out car with a burnt out engine for, hopefully, what do you think you find them for, like 100 or 200 bucks?
They're a little bit more than that, depending on the type of car.
Okay.
Like, you know, you can get them from auctions or, like, stuff like Copart and stuff like that. It's, you know, those are great. If you're going to do an engine swap anyways, you want to find the cars that no one else really wants. Like, we could specialize on one type of thing or one type of car, that's the best way to go. You don't want to diversify yourself too far and then not be good at anything.
Absolutely. All right. Well, so that we digressed a little bit on there, but you know, that is going to be one of our goals, is to do some standalone content on creating businesses and doing the junk scrap car, scrap part, scrap metal. That is part of it. So very exciting. Looking forward to doing that soon.
Yeah. And then also next week, we have a challenge video at Estate Sale. What we actually worked on today. That was a fun time. I'm not going to give away too much.
I might have just shown my poker face.
But it didn't go too well for me. Yeah. Anyways, we also have our two punishments.
Oh, yeah. We got to talk about that. Because you finished yours.
I finished mine.
Challenge complete for you, sir. Good job.
Challenge complete. You'll see how I did it next week on a video. And how about you, Justin? Are you done with yours yet?
Working. I'm a little over halfway on mine. So if you were watching last week, I had to spin the right behind me. We got three names for it now. It's the Wheel of Punishment. It's the Wheel of Opportunity. And the Wheel. What was the third one, BJ? I don't remember.
Of Excellence.
Yeah,
Wheel
sure.
Of Excellence.
The Wheel of Excellence.
All right.
So I think we'll just go with Punishment or Opportunity for right now. And so I had to spin that. And so I needed to sell $25 of profit on some sunglasses that we ordered on Amazon. We were thinking that I was really thinking that I could knock it out in a day or two. You know, the weather wasn't quite as cooperative earlier in the week. I did get a chance to go to the Ackworth Beach here in Ackworth, Georgia. I actually sold six pairs at the beach within 20 minutes.
That's not bad for, what was it, a Tuesday?
It was like a Tuesday at 4 in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So it definitely went a lot better than I expected. But I didn't complete the challenge quite yet. But that doesn't mean that it's over. I leave today to head back home. I'm actually going to Chicago for the weekend. But then I'll be back in Austin, Texas on Monday. There will be plenty of events in town throughout the week and on the weekend. There's places I can go, watering holes. Same kind of thing, or swimming holes, excuse me, like we went here in Ackworth, I can do in Austin. And I will definitely be able to sell probably the rest of those sunglasses, and then I can add to my bank and get closer to the challenge.
Yeah, the great thing about the punishment is it does add to your total. So, but still, to me, it's a punishment.
It is.
I did not enjoy washing those windows. Again, I have to be honest.
You know, but I think that that is going to be something also that we get to do, you know, as the challenge moves on, is really explain how, you know, we're doing these things that, I mean, I don't really have the desire to go to the beach and sell sunglasses, you know, like, but,
right.
And same thing with you, washing windows. But, you know, when you get yourself out of your comfort zone, you're there to make money. That's the point of a side hustle. Now, do I hate it? No, I don't hate it. Am I passionate about it? Probably not. But I am passionate about making money as a side hustle. So,
yeah.
Suck up your pride, check your ego at the door, and let's go. Let's go to the beach. Let's sell some sunglasses. So, sometimes you just got to do it, baby.
That is exactly what I had to do. It's like you just mentally psych yourself up, and you're like, all right, I'm walking in there. Do you need your windows washed today?
You know what's cool? I like how you got creative with it, though, too, because, you know, like when we first talked about it, you know, we thought, oh, you got to get a squeegee and you got to wash vehicle windows. Well, you did that your first day. It wasn't very successful.
Yeah.
But then you went to the businesses.
Yeah.
And that's where you're able to crush your goal in just a matter of, you know, a short amount of time.
It's like
right?
45 minutes.
Yeah. And so that was thinking outside the box where you're like, all right, this vehicle window is really not going to cut it. It's going to take way too long. Go to a couple businesses and then boom, you're done.
Yeah.
So good on you for thinking like that.
Yeah. I mean, you could make about $20, $30 an hour doing that. You really could.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, that's not bad. That's a good job.
All you need is a bucket, a squeegee, and some soap. And go walk around your local town, your downtown,
and
talk
some
to some businesses.
To ask some people.
Yeah, you do. You need those.
Pardon my French. Is that French? No. That's stream friendly.
We're edgy on this channel. It's okay. All right. What else do we want to talk about?
I don't know. I think we covered most of it, but I'm sure there's something. We talked about... Oh, yeah, sure. Let's talk about these items that I sold this week. Update on that. We bought this. Oh no, we got this for free in the trash.
This is when you were doing the windows too, right?
Yes, this actually sold right after the live stream last week.
How convenient, man! You're always selling things either right before or right after the stream.
It does have, you know, I have a lady like literally on her way here to like pick up the table that I got for free. Like she's gonna be here at like 3 o'clock, hopefully.
The lady in the stream who's now offering you half price.
No, yeah, now yeah. maybe she is. But yeah, $50 table that's going to sell that we got for free with that couch. We talked about that last week. So hopefully that sells. But, you know, like kind of, I guess, you know, we're talking about our system here. My system for like getting to where I am now has just been like scrolling Craigslist free every day and making sure I do it for like at least an hour or two.
TJ just walked by and definitely did some distracting
gestures.
Like one of those. Huh. That's fun. I love working here, man. Everyone's here is so cool.
And it's great. Yeah, there's always some. There was literally someone like new that just like walked in right before the stream started, and every day there's someone new, or it's just
or some kind of action, something fun going on.
Turns out he's an internal medicine doctor, so that's why I was almost late. We just nerded out.
You got to nerd out and talk medical talk, huh?
Oh, I loved it.
I know. DJ or BJ says some words that I could never even think about pronouncing.
Yeah.
Give us one real quick.
Cupcake.
No.
Thanks.
Thanks, man. Thanks for showing me. Oh, the Wheel of Destiny. That's what it was. Chris Jukum. Sorry if I butchered that. The Wheel of Destiny.
That's
right.
What it was.
So it's the Wheel of Punishment, Opportunity, and Destiny.
All right. So I'm gonna predict your destiny.
Oh man.
Today. I'm gonna try to guess. Last week I was feeling it. I didn't actually put the prediction on camera, and I regret it now because I would have looked like a superstar.
You are a superstar.
Well, thank you, Justin. So I am going to predict that you will get. I'm really feeling like more sunglasses.
No.
Just like pile on the challenge where you have to like double down and sell more. I'm really thinking that's what it's going to be.
So if let me ask you a question. If that's what happens, do we agree that I just need to sell the rest of the supply?
No, just you have to add that to your total. Well, there's a $50 one and a $25 one.
Oh, man.
So you have to add that to the $25 and sell that much in profit of the sunglasses.
If you're listening to this stream and you want to buy an entire box of sunglasses, they are for sale for the exact price that I need to get a profit to get out of this if that happens.
So we spin in this? I think we have a guest spinner.
We have a guest spinner?
Yeah.
Kate and Ashley Olsen.
Yeah. Let me
in the studio.
Bring them in.
Yeah. Why don't we bring them in?
I'll bring them in.
We'll spin the wheel. We'll see what. Oh, golly, man. This is like, you know, it's funny. I hosted Around the Blockchain
Instagram,
last night.
If you can't see the wheel, sorry. But, oh, there we go.
There we go. We got Mary Kate and Ashley in the house. You know, last night I had to host Around the Blockchain. And I think, you know, those videos get something like 100,000 views and whatnot. I was not as nervous. That was a terrible spin, BJ. Can I get like a, yes, there we go. I'm more nervous.
It wasn't BJ.
I'm sorry. Mary Kate and Ashley.
With respect.
Clean windows for $40 and tips.
Yes, now we have to make a combined video, Justin.
Oh, man. Oh, no.
Well, I have some supplies for sale.
I have a squeegee at home. Don't worry.
They might be half off.
Wait, Brian,
something.
I think you can make some profit selling them back.
Yeah.
It's used. There's no way. Remember, rules of the hustle.
I said half price.
You don't pay retail price. Man, that stinks. Like, I really wanted to be able to invest something. I really wanted to do something where I was adding more potential than washing windows. Oh, that irks me. Whatever. We'll still have fun doing it.
I already know it's going to suck.
I'm going to learn from your lead, and I'm going to go straight to the businesses because I am not going to be watching. In Austin, Texas, this is just a thing. But there's the guys that wash the windows, like at the interstate.
Oh, God, yeah.
And they always come up to wash the window, and I immediately say, no thanks. Get away from my car because I think it's poop water. I don't want them coming anywhere near my car.
Everyone in the office wanted me to do that. They're like, can you please go to an intersection and just spray people's cars and wash them? I was like, maybe
just
for the content, but I'll do the gas station instead.
You asked for a respin.
That's true. That's true. That was your
I wish we had some studio sound effects because that should be a... Oh, man.
The Wheel of Destiny speaks.
No, that's not destiny. That's punishment. I think if you get an investing one, if you get like when I got the scratch off tickets, like those are chances. That's an opportunity. Mm-hmm. This isn't an opportunity. This is a punishment.
Well,
but hey, we're going to do it. We're going to get, like I said earlier, suck up our pride, check our ego at the car door when we get to the businesses, because I'm going straight to businesses to try to wash those windows. And I've got a squeegee, so I'm not buying your products. I'm doing it my own.
God, you're so salty already.
Very salty.
I have some good products, man. I got like the, do you know the special mix that you need to get everything off the windows?
Vinegar and dish soap.
How
How did you know that? Because I'm a genius and a psychic. I just know Vinner. I know cleaning a window. So, like, I think I could be making.
He nailed it.
I could be making this up. But when I was a child, I had to wash a lot of windows or something. So I know it's like vinegar and newspaper are like the best things to use to clean a window.
Yeah, newspaper. But, like, yeah, vinegar, dish soap, and water. That's it.
And
all you need.
I have a squeegee, and I'll get some of those chamois towels or whatever.
Microfiber.
Microfiber. Thank
That'll
you.
That was, I got some of those for sale.
Don't you start
need those?
With me. I'll go to the dollar store and get some
God.
Before I buy yours. Let's see. I think that's pretty much everything for this week.
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
You did a great job.
We will see you next week, Friday at 2 o'clock. Please drop a like on the video while we are trying to rebrand and grow this channel.
Smash it.
Hit the subscribe button. We always love to spend time with you guys. Drop a comment below of the side hustle you want us to see do next.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll see you next time.
See you soon.